Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we will be discussing about Asus TUF A17 gaming laptop. We have been using this laptop for almost a month. So, here are the list of all the pros and cons that we have observed from our usage. Without any delay, let's dive into the video. Asus TUF Gaming comes in various configurations ranging from Intel based i5 10th gen processor, and also it also comes in different configurations of Ryzen series processors. Then one which we are using is AMD's Ryzen 5 4600H processor, which has 6 cores and 12 threads. This processor is accompanied with Nvidia's GTX 1650 4GB of graphics card. Looking at these specs, we can confidently say that this machine can handle all the demanding games with ease. Not only gaming, as it has 6 cores and 12 threads, it is very good at multitasking, video editing and day-to-day tasks. We were using this laptop for content creation and a little bit of gaming too. And we would say it has handled all the tasks with ease. Asus TUF comes with Ryzen 5 4600H processor along with GTX 1650 4GB of graphics card. It also comes with 8GB of DDR4 3200MHz RAM. Coming to internal, it comes with 1TB hard drive at a price point of approximately 62,000. These are some decent specs that we get along with great performance in hand. But even greater is the upgradability options available for you. You can upgrade the RAM up to 32GB, which has two RAM slots. One comes with 8GB of stick. Also, we can upgrade the storage as well. It has two NVMe slots free. We have upgraded our storage with 500GB NVMe SSD stick. We will provide the link below so that you can check out it later. We have upgraded our machine with 500GB SSD stick. That has cost us around 7,000 rupees. Upgrading your RAM with another 3200MHz 8GB stick will also cost around 8K, which makes it worth the upgrade. Because the RAM is the only thing which is bottlenecking this machine, with stock single channel RAM setup. After considering the upgrades, the total cost of the machine would be around 76,000 rupees. But I am sure you will get all three components under 75K. Which makes this machine a well-rounded one within 75K compared to other manufacturers such as Acer, Predator, HP Pavilion Gaming, MSI GF65. I know those machines have very good cooling systems than this one, but considering our usage and the amount of gaming that we do on this machine, this one is a lot better option for us. Also, that I have to mention, this one comes with military grade certification. It has shockproof certification as well. Today I am thankful that I went for this instead of other laptop, because I have already dropped this machine a couple of times, and one of these is very nasty fall. If it would have been any other laptop, some major component would have been damaged, such as display. The display on this thing is not very great, but I would say it will get the job done. It is anti-glare, which is good, and it covers 45% of NTSC and 67% of sRGB and 50% of Adobe RGB. Colors on this display is not accurate. Brightness is also fairly decent in this display. Coming to the keyboard, it has chiclet style RGB single zone keyboard. The key travel is good, and also the overall typing experience is also good enough, I would say. Battery on this machine is 48 hour lithium ion battery, and if we are not gaming on this, little bit of browsing and content watching such as movies and etc, we'll get around 2.5 to 3 hours of battery backup in this one. And if you are gaming on battery, it uses the onboard Radeon graphics instead of GTX one, so you won't get much of the performance while you are in battery mode. Although the fans are little bit loud, in performance or turbo mode. The performance of this laptop is fairly good in those modes. We have tested GTA 5, also other racing games. The graphics is good with decent frame rate. So we are happy with the test that we have done with this one. We are using most of the CAD softwares in this laptop, which were performing surprisingly well. Some of the softwares are SolidWorks, Creo and Ansys. We didn't see any hiccups or any obstacles while we are using these remaining softwares. We also used Ansys and some other simulations. The render times and solving times are not that high. We would say there are some occasions while we have to wait a bit longer, but in performance and turbo modes the solving times are quite low and we don't have to much worry about using this laptop for CAD or analysis. Coming to video editing such as Adobe After Effects and Premiere Pro, it does handle them quite well as well. We didn't have a moment where the application freezes for a while or crashes. The laptop comes with Asus ArmoryGrid software from which we can monitor all the voltages, temperatures, fan speeds, etc. We can also control RGB effects of keyboard, and also we can connect it with our mobile phone and we can use it remotely. Display on this laptop is only 60Hz. I would say this one is more preferable because according with these specs we cannot achieve crazy frame rates such as 200fps, 150fps, etc. We will be getting around 60 or 70fps. I would say without the internals that can push the FPS up to our average above 100, there would be no usage of higher FPS display for these specs. For a CAD developer or content creator, I would say go for 17-inch laptop instead of 15-inch. Portability is not a great concern for you, because you will get a larger display, means you would have lot more space to work on, which makes your task a bit more easier. Here is a sample of fan noise that you can hear in silent mode. This is a fan noise at performance mode. This is a fan noise at turbo mode. The machine comes with 150W power adapter. This does charge your laptop from 0 to 100 in about 1.5 hours. The webcam that is provided is 720p, and as other laptop, the quality is not quite good or great. Touchpad is precise, but the left and right keys provided along with the touchpad is not that clicky and satisfactory. All the available ports and connectivity options will be displayed on your screen. These are our thoughts on this machine. If you are a serious gamer who games on for hours and hours continuously, maybe this is not a good option for you. But if you are a content creator and who does a little bit of gaming and other tasks, maybe this is a very good option for you and you can go for it. This wraps up our thoughts on this machine. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more future videos. Thank you.